Hi, everybody. My name is Lydia Gutterman, and I'm the Library Outreach Coordinator for PLIX, the Public Library Innovation Exchange. PLIX is a project of the MIT Media Lab, our digital learning and collaboration studio. And PLIX connects library professionals and MIT Media Lab researchers to co-design learning experiences, develop and share facilitation practices, and integrate creative learning into public library programming. PLIX strives to increase equitable access to and broaden participation in STEAM programming. And before I tell you a little bit more about our work and our collaboration with Karen and Thomas, I just wanted to thank them for having us today, or having me today. Thanks. So I mentioned creative learning. What is that? Well, the pedagogy of creative learning has grown out of the work of Mitchell Resnick, a professor at the lab. When we talk about creative learning, we like to explain it best using the four P's: projects, passion, play, and peers. We believe that people learn best when they are working on projects that they are passionate about in collaboration with peers, and in an environment that is playful or makes it safe for them to experiment and take risks. To facilitate a creative learning experience is less about expertise and content knowledge and more about cultivating this environment in which participants can tinker and mess around and express themselves creatively. So why do we bring this creative learning and facilitator outlook to libraries? Like you all, we think libraries and public libraries particularly are amazing. So a few reasons why: libraries support and encourage patron curiosity. They provide free access to an abundance of resources and programs. The environment is casual and safe and flexible to patron needs. Maybe not in the US right now, but oftentimes, libraries are a convening place for the communities that they serve, and they provide far more than books and are a place for social change and innovation, from makerspaces to recording studios to early literacy programs. Librarians and libraries are working hard to create open, collaborative, community-oriented environments where learning can flourish. So PLIX offers a number of things. We offer activities, which I'll talk a little bit more about in a sec. We offer facilitator resources, both for our activities and beyond, just getting started information and tips for creating creative learning experiences for your patrons. Online and in person, we have community events like our online discussion forum and online and in-person professional development workshops. So our activities are creative STEAM learning experiences, and they're based on Media Lab research and designed for the public library setting. I'm talking a little bit more about CubeSats today because that's what we worked on with Karen and Thomas. PLIX CubeSats is designed to offer patrons a way to experience the simulated lifestyle of spacecraft design, testing, and launch. Through engaging in a creative design process over three workshops, patrons will build out their own satellite design and use it to collect data with a payload of their choosing. Along the way, they'll learn about the functions of and the engineering pipeline for satellites. So our work with Thomas and Karen started after a Next Library presentation in Berlin, which I believe was in June 2018, or maybe September 2018. I don't know. This presentation is pre-recorded, so no one can correct me right now. So I hope that that's right. Anyways, over a few months in 2019, we collaborated with them to run CubeSats at the Ballerup Library and in collaboration with DTU. They ran sessions for the general public and for high school students. So Karen and Thomas, our wonderful library staff, were the expert facilitators, and DTU provided the technical expertise. So it was a room, a field full of experts. And just some takeaways for the CubeSats program, which I think in collaboration with Karen and Thomas went wonderfully. It was a pleasure to work with you both. The CubeSats program is a great way to talk about climate change, which is, climate action is one of the sustainable development goals of the UN. It's a great way to talk about climate change with patrons because it's a creative and playful, friendly, but still serious introduction or continuing education of climate change through different things of climate sensing satellites or data collection. And it can really open up a dialogue about how technology can be used to track global climate change or global restoration. Just a larger goal of PLIX is pretty much in line with goal 4 of quality education and obtain, and we agree with the belief from the UN that obtaining a quality education is the foundation to improving people's lives and sustainable development. Our projects promote equitable access to wonderful learning opportunities and to make our materials accessible and usually low or no tech. And then I just kind of wanted to end off with some notes about collaborating. And I would say university and public library partnerships are a great way for scientists to get their research out to a broader audience and give new learning opportunities for patrons. So PLIX is a direct collaboration between the Media Lab and public libraries. The university researchers partner with our learning design expertise, and we then publicly and broadly share these educational programs with the public libraries, or through the public libraries. And there's also, along with us, an opportunity for libraries to partner with local universities or local experts to deliver these programs, just like Karen and Thomas did with DTU. And I think we all think it worked out really well. So I encourage you to either work with us or collaborate with your local experts or scientists. So that's all for me. Again, I wanted to thank Karen and Thomas for having me and for letting me represent PLIX today. It's been a pleasure to work with you both, and I'm excited to get to talk to you all. If you want to learn more about our work, you can head to, plix.media.mit.edu. All right. Have a great rest of your day, everyone.